It's Madden Ratings Reveal Week here on ESPN, and today we're breaking down the top two highest-rated quarterbacks in the video game Madden NFL 25. Coming in as the second highest-rated quarterback is Lamar Jackson with a 98 overall rating, and the top quarterback in this year's game is Patrick Mahomes, rated 99 overall. Ashley A. Martin, Damian Woody back here with us in Chicago. And Damian, I'll start with you. Is Lamar the second best quarterback in the NFL behind Patrick Mahomes?
He is. He is, absolutely. I mean, listen, Lamar Jackson was operating in a new system, Todd Monken, first year. You know, all Lamar Jackson did was had his best passing season in his whole career, leading to a second MVP. I know people want to get, you know, want to get tied up into what happened in the AFC Championship game against the Kansas City Chiefs. Listen, that's what happens when you go against a GOAT, a living GOAT right now in Patrick Mahomes. And oh, by the way, if that offensive coordinator had ran the ball more, we might be talking about a different outcome in that football game. Okay, but what Lamar Jackson has done since he's been in the National Football League has been one of the most dynamic quarterbacks, both passing and running the football. Forget all this, you know, all this, the people out there talking about, oh, he's just a running quarterback. Have people not watched Lamar Jackson in the pocket? Have people not watched Lamar Jackson do the things that he's doing through the air since he's been in the National Football League? So forget me with all of that stuff about being a running quarterback. This man is one of the best dual threat quarterbacks, one of the best quarterbacks that we have in the National Football League. All he needs to do now is go out here and win a chip, because he's one of any quarterback in NFL history that's won two or more MVPs. He's the last one standing. He just needs to fulfill that. And we're talking about Lamar Jackson, a whole different category.
Listen, no one loves Lamar Jackson more than me, because I sat there and watched him when he was getting right at the combine, when people were asking him, can you even play this position? Do you think you should switch positions? And I remember thinking, this kid is going to shock a lot of people, all these doubters. But the question about, is he the second best quarterback in the NFL? I would say no. And I love Lamar Jackson, but what is his record in the playoffs? You talk about, like, oh, people want to bring up the AFC Championship. Yeah, because of how he played. How he played, how the Ravens played against a Chiefs team that throughout most of that game did not look like a good team at that point. Did not look. The Ravens could have beaten them, and they forgot who they were. They forgot.
Is that Lamar Jackson's fault?
Yes. Because
okay.
You can
go ahead.
Listen, you can love the talent that Lamar Jackson has. You can see that he has two MVPs, and you can say, bro, you are talented enough. Last year, they should have won the Super Bowl.
So who's your guy?
Burrow. You know why? You know why? You know why? Joe Burrow, because in his last two, listen, since he came in the league, he's been hurt a couple years. But has he gotten to the Super Bowl? Has he gotten to a Super Bowl?
Yeah, he's gotten there.
Okay. So when we measure athletes, when we talk about expectations, we talk about standards, as you were getting on me earlier, we're talking about the standard is a standard, right? He's gotten to a Super Bowl. Lost by 3 points. In the playoff games that he's lost by 3 points.
Okay.
And we never question, when Joe Burrow is healthy, he is
lethal.
See
how you qualify everything? When Joe Burrow's healthy. Have we not sat here and said the best ability is availability? That man can't stay on the field.
Let me chime in.
Wait.
Go ahead, Stephen.
Damian,
go ahead.
Let me chime in. I'm a side with Damian here, Kimberly, but I don't think you're far off. I understand when you look at Joe Burrow, he got to a Super Bowl. When you look at his performance in the AFC Championship game, you don't look at the Cincinnati Bengals and you're able to look at him and say he didn't get the job done. So I get what you're saying. Here's the issue, though. When you look at Lamar Jackson, not only is he a two-time league MVP, he's also had the best record in football two seasons. Mm-hmm. And so he shows up. We understand that, at least during the regular season. We have to take into account him being bereft of the kind of talent that Joe Burrow has had available to him. Jamar Chase and T. Higgins are no joke. Lamar Jackson ain't had that available to him. He hasn't had that at his disposal. And he's the only league MVP since 1986 with Brett Favre that has done what he has done without a 1,000-yard receiver and without a 1,000-yard rusher. And so when we look at it from that perspective, we have to understand that Lamar Jackson is a mercurial talent who is box office, who is a difference maker because of his dual capability. And if you really look at it, he's 1-4 against Patrick Mahomes, if I remember correctly, okay? So Patrick Mahomes has got his number. But anybody else he's going against, he's giving them a run for his money, or he's flat out taking them out. And so when we look at that and we look at the lack of personnel that the Baltimore Ravens have given him and how he has succeeded anyway, and then you put on top of that the fact that he got his bag and then went out there and produced after he got his bag, okay? All of those things come into play that makes you say, Lamar Jackson is just a special kind of dude, 1,000%. And we can't summarily dismiss that.
1,000%. Nobody is saying that. But what I'm trying to bring perspective, and I want to keep things even how we evaluate quarterbacks, it always shifts. So Lamar Jackson, when I say he's not the second best quarterback, that's not to say I don't think he's going to be great. I don't think he's a great talent. But when you look at him to be a two-time MVP, he has raised the expectations for himself. And we talk about the Cowboys. Why do you always get on the Cowboys? Because in the regular season, they're great. And then what happens?
Yeah.
They don't show up.
Yeah, yeah.
When you look at the Dolphins, oh, they're great.
Nah,
it's sunny,
Kimberly.
South Florida.
Those comparisons don't work.
No. It does because
We saw panic from the Cowboys. We literally saw them shaking. You understand what I'm saying? They were panicked. I mean, moment was too big for
Stephen
them.
Stephen A., we have 30 seconds, top of the hour. Game on the line and the team's behind. Who are you trusting, Lamar Jackson or Joe Burrow?
I'm going to go
Joe Burrow because he can throw the football better. All right, let's go to break.
Dang. I'll just spin something.
This is a circus act. Am I not?
America likes it, yeah. RC, no one loves movie references more than you do.
That was a doo-doo moment. That ain't hit how he thought it was going to hit.
I'm not sure any of that makes sense. Parenthetically, why do we have a book that says Cezanne on it?
There's a lot of weird things around this studio.
This was video from Saturday that everyone I know sent me.
I find it hilarious that you are probably conflicted because as a TV host, you want it to be something so, so bad.
And they're going to be fine. They love each other. And they do. They love each other. They love each other. They both told me that. You should work in politics. Your spin is so good. Actually, we're going to start smashing some helmets. Jeff, you're excited.
Very excited. Beat. Do you want to stand back? Uh-oh.
Oh, Tampa. I flew a long way.
Yeah, it did. It did.
This is very dangerous. That's my laptop. Please take good care of it.
Greeny, this doesn't matter. None of this matters.
We got to get to the games.
Get to the games.
We got to get to the games.
Kick the ball off.
We got to get to the games here.
For crying out loud. That was fun.
Nobody makes me spin stuff like you do.
No one can spin stuff like you can. It's a ridiculous talent. I don't know if it ever gets you anywhere. I mean, I'm not sure.
It got me here because certainly wasn't my football acumen.
Is there any obvious upside to being able to do that stuff? It's just
a great party trick.
I guess that's true. Fair enough. All right, that's one more party trick than I have, I guess. That's why I don't go to parties. Okay, let's get back to some football here. Teddy Bruschi is with us. Let's play a game of more or less. We're talking about the AFC East. We got win totals from our friends at ESPN Bet. Jeff, let's start with Buffalo. The total is 10.5 wins. You going more or less?
I'm saying less, and not because I don't believe in Josh Allen. I think that I can make a case he's the number two quarterback in the NFL. I just want to see what happens without the wide receivers around him and Gabe Davis and Stephon Diggs. Keon Coleman is showing out at camp. Maybe he fills in and puts this team over that hump. But for right now, until further notice, I am going to say less for the Buffalo Bills.
Teddy, let's do the Dolphins. Their number is at 9.5 wins. You go more or less?
9.5 wins, but I'm going to go more for the Miami Dolphins. I mean, I'm a Tua fan. I know he got paid big time recently, but this is a quarterback in an offense that continued to evolve as the course of the season went on, developing adjustments off of their new adjustments. And I think McDaniel is just a great offensive coach. I think it's above. This is going to be a great football team this year if they just don't limp to the finish.
It's a very interesting division. And then finally, Greeny, I will ask you, the total on the Jets is 9.5 wins. Are you going more or less? Well, I'm glad you asked me that. The answer is way more. I mean, are we kidding? 9.5 wins?